Nectar 2 and VocalSynth are powerful tools in their own right, but combining them onto one vocal track unlocks a world of creative possibilities. For example, I have a dry lead vocal which could use some harmony and some character. I'll use one instance of Nectar 2 to shape the vocal, and another to add rich, natural backing vocals, even though this track only features one singer. Now I've chosen the Pop, Bright, and Clean preset, which features a de-esser to take care of sibilance, an EQ curve which highlights the high-end frequencies, two compressors in parallel to lift and even out the performance, and a touch of reverb. I have another instance of Nectar 2 which is adding rich top-end harmonies, and as you can see, I'm automating the plugin on and off for effect. Here's the before. Years after.
This is crazy. You got your head in your hands, head in your hands now. Not looking at me, and it's too hard to breathe while you're ripping my heart out.
Now, underneath this on another track, I have VocalSynth in MIDI mode so I can add futuristic tones to affect this duplicate lead vocal track. I've turned VocalSynth up pretty high so you can really hear its effects. Let's have a listen to the MIDI that I wrote in for it.
This is crazy. You got your head in your hands, head in your hands now. Not looking at me, and it's too hard to breathe while you're ripping my heart out. What do you want me? What do you want me to say?
So for this sound, I'm using a touch of delay and two modules, Talkbox and Polyvox. I'm using the Pipe Dream preset on the Talkbox module and altering its formant to really shake up this straightforward pop vocal. Let's do a big before and after to all our processing. So here's before.
You got your head in your hands, head in your hands now. Not looking at me, and it's too hard to breathe while you're ripping my heart out. What do you want me? What do you want me to say? What do you need me?
Show your next vocal some love with VocalSynth and Nectar 2.